AskReddit. What unfair way did a teacher treat you but nobody else? Some twat science teacher pulled me up in front of the headmistress because I got egged on my 13th birthday as I was leaving school. So, I got in trouble for being hit by an egg. Fortunately, the head of year was a super cool guy and shoot him out for being a fucking dickhead. Year 4. Possibly my best and worst year ever. The start, I had Miss Nguyen, really nice and caring and funny. Then I took a trip around Australia and this new teacher took over when I got back. She immediately hated me for missing school and she would put me on the corner of the computer desks, back facing everyone, and the board for me to permanently sit. She used to mock my mistakes in front of the class and never acknowledge my hard work. Thank God she got fired. My P. teacher from middle school watched me get bullied time and time again. One time, I stood up for myself in the locker room by cursing at a girl who had me pinned up against a locker. She gave me detention and told me that it was my fault for drawing attention to myself and being a weird kid. She was always buddy-buddy with the popular kids. My 8th grade yearbook has her signature in it. It reads, "I hope you make more friends in high school. One friend isn't gonna cut it." This same teacher runs a campaign online for anti-bullying called #ICANHELP. My little sister was a part of it. I think it's absolute horseshit. I had a teacher in middle school who was universally loved by everyone. He was the best teacher in that school and everyone knew it. He always made every kid feel like an individual and encouraged them to do their best. I loved his class so much. Then the next year I came out as gay and he stopped talking to me. No high fives in the halls. No good mornings. He wouldn't even look at me anymore and ignored me and me alone while walking with friends past his class. Fucked me up for a little bee. My art teacher at school hated me for no reason. She usually scolded me for doing something I had not done, screamed at me. I was about 11, if I recall correctly. I would often cry after her classes, but never told my parents, as I tried to be an adult in their eyes and kept problems to myself. The breaking point was when she refused to give me the points at the end of a semester, and when I asked her to do so, as I was having perfect grades in other classes, she said that I had to bring 5 different projects for the next day. One would be a picture drawn in watercolor, other with pencils, one picture made of paper clippings, one picture with gouache and something made of plasticine. I spent the whole night doing it as a kid. I was trying so hard, and those were really nice works. The next day, when I turned them in, she threw them to the ground and said there was no way I could do it by myself and that she won't accept something my parents did for me. I had a breakdown and another teacher, who saw me in the hallway, had to call my parents. I finally confessed to them what was going on and they unleashed hell on that teacher, along with the principal. The principal was a very cool lady and she gave me an order to go to her whenever I felt that this teacher would be bullying me. As the teacher was standing there, red of shame and anger. Never had a problem with her ever since. Year 2, I had a mean substitute. It was 2:30, time to catch the bus, so I would leave class a few minutes early. Most kids were from the neighborhood, so they walked slash got picked up. The sub literally blocked the doorway, so I couldn't leave. My 7y/0 self was frightened to miss the bus, because I had literally no other option to get home. So I tried to sneak through. She stopped me again. This time, she said back quote, "Don't make me call the principal." I said back quote, "Call her, at least she might understand my situation." By God's grace, the bus was a bit late that day, so I ended up narrowly catching it. I dyed my hair last year. It was sorta bright, but I'd consulted my head of year, and she said it was fine. Out of nowhere, once I did it, the assistant head, who also taught me, developed this vendetta against me for it. I'd constantly be punished for stuff everyone was doing, and she even failed me on a project that the rest of my group got A's on. This was admitted by the head of the course, but alas, this would have been mildly understandable if 3 other people in my year didn't also dye their hair and have it ignored. I had a math teacher in 3rd grade that said stuff like girls can't be good at math. Well, I was, so I got sent out of class 80% of the time, for no apparent reason. The school thought it was okay, because I still got good grade. I have posted this before. My maths teacher really made my life miserable. Between the ages of 14 and 16 I hit a big growth spurt. I went from 5 feet 7 to 8 inches to 6 feet 2 to 3 inches. As you can imagine, teenage me was very awkward with these suddenly huge limbs. In school the desks were too low, and I had to sit in a very clumsy folded way. For some reason this really offended my maths teacher. She used to literally scream at me to sit up straight and position my legs properly. When I actually did this, my straightened legs simply lifted the desk up from the floor. This only made her more furious, and she would scream even more. I had no idea what I was supposed to do about this. My AppGov teacher noticed I had an EMT book open, because I was studying to become one, and held it up in front of everyone. It was the reproductive chapter. I'm going in the opposite direction. My teachers absolutely loved me to an unreasonable degree. Back in middle school I was not only the teacher's pet, but also the principal's pet. My school was part of a chain of schools around the country, and 2 years in a row I managed to be the best student across all schools in a nationwide competition. This meant that the CEO of the chain came to give me a prize 2 years in a row, and the principal absolutely loved that. When a delegation from the UK came to visit, guess who she assigned to show them around? Since I was a good student and the principal loved me, and the school wasn't particularly good, I could get away with a whole bunch of stuff. I had an English teacher almost celebrate when she found an error in my homework, because she would almost just give me an A without even checking my work. I could get caught using the school computers, of which there were a ton, to play Line Rider, and they'd just ask me to maybe not do it again instead of actually caring about me doing it. But this all reached its peak after a history exam. I had gotten the equivalent of a C on the exam, and a few days after the results came back my teacher wanted to talk to me. We go into this separate room, and he says that he knows that I can do better, so if I wanted to we could go through the course material and discuss it a bit. Of course I say yes, and he basically starts holding a lecture in front of me, ending each segment with, "But you know that, right?" To which I would just nod. He asked me some really easy questions, and when we were done he said, "Alright, it's clear that you actually know this stuff, I'll just change your result to an A." I live in Belgium, so I don't know how the years and grades translate to other countries, but I just turned 13 at the time. Belgium has two different zones, one where they speak Dutch and one French. I had just moved from a Dutch area to a French, so I had to learn French and change schools. The school was fairly big and the people in it were pretty racist. Luckily my class wasn't as much. I made a friend as well. French wasn't as very difficult to me, so I had trouble following in class. For a lot of classes I had a very nice teacher. He was British and the best teacher I've ever had. The others though didn't speak much of English, so I was stuck with them. One of the teachers had given up with me, and would never answer my questions, talk to me or anything along those lines. So I always had a zero with her. Luckily I've moved back to a Dutch area and now it's much easier to follow the lessons. My English teacher extended all my deadlines to ridiculous amounts, but only for me. I don't know if she thought I was challenged, or understood that my ADHD interferes with my ability to do desk work. All in all I don't know if it helped. I graduated with good grades, but I did learn it's okay to procrastinate. I'm not sure if I would've learned not to procrastinate had he not extended the deadlines for me, however. I had a teacher crumple up my work, call it bad and throw it in the garbage in front of me because it hadn't lived up to her standards. I'd worked pretty hard on it, I think it was analyzing a poem or something, and it devastated me so badly I left class. There was this one sub I had in grade 4 that really hated me for some reason, and would take any chance to punish me, no matter how minor the offense. For example, some kid told a funny joke in class. Everyone laughed. I was the only one to get in trouble. It always annoyed me so much. My teacher for year 12 chemistry was one of my worst. She spent most of the year ignoring my existence, would not listen to me when I asked questions. She would try and force me to leave the class because she didn't think I was good enough when there were students that had scores worse than mine. She told my mother that I was behind in class and gave me a list of things to complete that would help me catch up. It was a list of all the assignments I had already completed. We had a poster assignment during the year, mine was mostly complete, but I ran out of time and just handed it in. My name was on the back. When returning the poster, she had given everyone else's back and then held up my incomplete one and said, "Who did this one? I can't find a name on it." She deliberately showed it to the whole class. I had a meltdown in class once, crying, grasping for air. It was one of the most terrifying experiences of my life. As far as I know, she didn't even glance at me. She just continued talking to the class, as if nothing was happening. Everyone around me loves her and thinks that she is a great teacher, my mother in particular, but I will never forgive her for what she did. I can honestly say that she is a big part of why I missed out on my top 3 uni preference.